So now I will show you how you can use Smarteefi app. It's available both on Apple App Store as well as on Google Play Store. So I have already downloaded it, and here we have the Smarteefi app. The first screen that you will see is the login screen. If you already have a Smarteefi account, then you can just log in with your email and password. If this is the first time you are going to use Smarteefi product, you need to create an account. So here you can see an option, create new account. When you create a new account, you need to enter your email ID. So let me enter my email ID. And then I need to choose my password. And when you do a register, so you see a message that email activation required. We have sent you email with the account activation link. Please activate your account before login. Here we see that we have received an activation email from the Smarteefi administrator. And here we see a link to activate the account. If we press on this link, our account is activated now. So we can now log in to the Smarteefi app. So now our account is activated, so we can log in to the Smarteefi app. I have entered the email and the password that we just have registered and activated. So I am inside the app, and since there is no device added in my account, this is the first time I'm using. Then we need to add first the device. So here with the add button, you can add the device, and it will ask you the serial number and the activation code, which is printed, for example, on the back of our power strip. So let me take it from here and enter it. So we have entered both the serial number and the activation code, and if we press the add button, the device is added in our account. So we have this device added in our account, but it's not yet configured. So it is prompting you to configure the device. So it's asking Wi-Fi configuration is required for the device to connect with your router internet. Press next. It will check the device mode. So it's showing whether your device is in the settings mode or not. So currently it's not in the settings mode, so we need to put it into the settings mode. So it's showing that please change the device mode to setting. This is our, as I explained earlier, the first switch is the setting switch. So if we keep pressing it for 5 seconds, the color of the LED will change to the blue, stable blue. So my device is now in the settings mode. Now we go next. So it has already detected my current Wi-Fi network in my office, and its name is Smarteefi. So it's asking whether we want to configure the device with this particular router or this particular Wi-Fi. I say yes, and then it's asking for the password. This password is the password of your home Wi-Fi network. Whatever Wi-Fi network is detected, it will be shown here. So I am entering the Wi-Fi password. So now I have entered the password. It's asking me whether do you see the stable blue light, your device is in the settings mode, and I say confirm. Smarteefi is on the iPhone, it may prompt you to join the network. So what will happen now, the app will try to connect to the power strip and configure the Wi-Fi settings. So I say join. It will take some time to connect to the Smarteefi power strip. Okay, here it says your current Wi-Fi settings which are stored. So by default with the factory we set my Wi-Fi, my password, which it's asking to change to the Wi-Fi name that you just have configured. And let's do a change. So when you change and the change happens successfully, the blue light will automatically change to the blinking green. And if both name passwords are correct and your Wi-Fi router is on, it should become stable. So here my green light become stable. That means my Wi-Fi has been configured successfully, and that's the message you get on the app. With success, your Wi-Fi parameters are configured successfully. If it gives you an error, for example, iOS 10 and below, you need to manually connect your phone to the power strip. How you can do that is when it's in the settings mode. So if I put it again in the settings mode, so now it's in the settings mode, I need to go to my Wi-Fi. And here, based on the serial number of my device, I need to connect to that particular device. But from iOS 11, you don't need to do anything. Everything is done in the Smarteefi app itself. So my Wi-Fi is connected. And anytime if I press it again for 5 seconds, it will change its status to the normal mode. So now it's in the normal mode. It's attempting to connect to our Wi-Fi network. The blinking green indicates that there is an attempt going to connect a smart power strip to the Smarteefi cloud. The green stable means it successfully connected to the cloud, and now it's ready to be controlled using the app. So we have everything, our Wi-Fi is set up. Now our power strip is ready to be controlled from our mobile phone. So let's go to the dashboard. We see three switches: switch 1, switch 2, switch 3. Here I can go to the switch 1 and try to. So currently the green indicates the switch is currently on. If I off, the switch is off on the power strip. If I switch it on, I can similarly go back. And let's try switch 3 this time. Switch off, switch on. This is how you can configure your Wi-Fi settings. Once the Wi-Fi setting is done, then your configuration is complete and you can control the power strip or Smarteefi switch or Smarteefi switchboard from the Smarteefi app.